मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. तो टुडे आई एम ऑन माई वे टू परामलाई टेम्पल. परामलाई टेम्पल इज़ बेसिकली लोकेटेड इन द सबर्ब्स ऑफ कोयम्बटूर. फ्रॉम कोयम्बटूर इट्स अप्रॉक्सीमेटली टू आवर्स ड्राइव एंड रोड्स कंडीशन इज प्रीटी फाइन. यू कैन लाइक ड्राइव, इट्स लाइक अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 40 किलोमीटर्स एंड यू कैन ड्राइव एंड कम अप एंड स्पेंड सम टाइम एंड देन गो बैक. सो टिल लाइक इट्स मोर From here it's like more 8 kilometers. So let's see you at the top. So far the journey has been beautiful and this place is not much like not much talked about, but coincidentally I read about the place and so I decided to come on this Sunday. So let's see how the rest of the things goes up and how the views are. Day is like quite sunny and pretty hot. So probably I think it's better to come like early morning or the evening time, but let's see what lies ahead. Now I'm trekking to the forest. You can trek to the temple or you can drive. So first I went with my bike and then left my bike and then walked down to the trekking route and it's a beautiful view. And it is believed that there are elephants, leopards and some other wild animals. I wish they should not come on my way. That's a beautiful view. Calm and peaceful, so many, you know, birds, sounds. And that's what all about wilderness. In spite of being alone in this forest, you never feel alone. You always feel beautiful. You can see this like umbrella shaped tree in front of the mountains and the green pasture like meadows. It's beautiful. Hopefully in monsoon it will be like more beautiful. So probably during monsoon I will try to come again and a few colorful wild flowers. is like long winding roads, little bit 4-5 kilometers, but roads are very fine that you can drive, as well as there is one 4-5 kilometers of jungle trek. If you wish to trek down, you can trek through the forest and walk down to this temple, and this is a very peaceful and calm location. So this temple gets crowded mainly on full moons like Saturdays, and there's a long history, like it's a very old temple and there are many legends, like 2-3 stories which I came across. So I will let you know about the story. Let's first visit the temple. Let's have a glimpse of it. It is believed that this was a thick and dense forest area. A villager who allowed his cow to graze here found that there was no milk left in the cow. One day, as he watched closely, he was amazed to find the milk on the Swayambhu Lord that had come up here. It is believed that the invisible voice sent him a message that he should bring milk from next morning. So the delighted villager followed this practice every morning. So today, this day, every morning inside the temple, the small idol of the Swayambhu Lord is presented, the milk abhisheka, as a part of morning puja, and you will find a lot of cows like roaming here. So the first story related with this temple is the liberation from Vasishtha's curse. The story goes that the Gandharva Dudharman was bathing in the tank with women. Maharishi Vasishtha, who was returning after visiting Lord Shiva, got due regards from all the women who came out of the tank and sought his blessings. However, the Gandharva disregarded the presence of the Rishi and continued to ignore him and remain bathing in the tank. This made Vasishtha Rishi quite angry. And so, angry Vasishtha Rishi cursed Gandharva to turn to a Rakshas. Shocked at this sudden turn of event, the woman folks pleaded the Rishi to bring the Gandharva back to his handsome form. And so the time passed and this Gandharva remained a Rakshasa and kept roaming in the forest. Over the time, Kalva Rishi, who was undertaking penance here, invoking the blessings of Lord Narayana, he was continuously harassed by this Gandharva turned Rakshasa. Perturbed at this, the Rishi increased the severity of his penance. Blessed with his prayers, Lord Narayana appeared before the Rishi and killed the Rakshasa with his Sudarshan Chakra, and thus liberating Gandharva from his curse and helping him unite with his Gandharva wife. So the Kalva Rishi requested the Lord to stay back here and provide darshan to the devotees in the same standing posture as Ranganatha. So this is the one story which is quite related to this temple.